Now we turn to the question of halting. As we have seen, not being able to tell whether a program will halt or not plays a central role in the diagonalization paradox. And it's at least partly intuitive that we can't tell whether a program is just taking a long time or if it will run forever. It shouldn't be surprising, then, that given an arbitrary program input pair, we can't decide whether the program will halt on that input. But actually, the situation is much more extreme. We can't even decide if a program will halt when it is given no input at all, just the empty string. Let's go ahead and prove this. The language of descriptions of Turing machines that halt on the empty string is undecidable. We'll do this by reducing from the diagonal language. That is, we'll show that the halting problem is at least as hard as the diagonal problem. Here is one of many possible reductions. The reduction creates a machine N that simply ignores the input and then runs the machine M on itself. If M rejects, then N is going to loop. Otherwise, N accepts. Note that because we're switching from a language about accepting to a language about halting, we have to return a rejecting non-acceptance into a looping one. The end result here is that if M accepts its own description, then N accepts every string, the empty one in particular. On the other hand, if M either rejects or loops on itself, then N will loop. A decider for the halting problem could tell the difference between accepting everything and looping on everything, so the reduction is complete.
At this point, it might seem that we've just done a bit of symbol manipulation, but let's step back and realize what we've just seen. We showed that no Turing machine can tell whether or not a computer program will halt or remain in a loop forever. This is a problem that we care about, and we can't solve it on a Turing machine or any other kind of computer. You can't solve the halting problem on your iPhone. You can't solve the halting problem on your desktop, no matter how many cores you have. You can't solve the halting problem in the cloud. Even if someone invents a quantum computer, it still won't be able to solve the halting problem. To misquote Nick Selby, if you want to solve the halting problem, you're at Georgia Tech, but you still can't do that. It's not just the halting problem we can't solve, but we can't determine pretty much anything about what a computer does. Let's keep going.